Welcome back. We're going to show you a live look outside in Rayleigh Field where it's beautiful out there. We have sunny skies overhead. It looks just gorgeous today. And unfortunately, while the valley's starting off in the 30s, we'll be warming up into the 60s without any rainfall in the forecast. In fact, your 7-day forecast shows that we're showing 7 days of pretty much sunshine. We do have a few clouds in there for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Unfortunately, those clouds won't bring us any rainfall. However, I think the weather is perfect for having a little bit of soup.
Soup sounds great. Evan's kitchen is in the house. We have Evan Elsberry, and he's doing a 5-course dinner, all including wine and cheese. So tell us about this fabulous meal that you have going.
Well, we're
going
to do a winemaker's dinner, which we do pretty much monthly, except for the holiday season. This one's kind of fun because we're using two other local businesses. We're going to use the Cultured and the Cured. It's a new business on 36th and J Street. We're using all their cheeses. And Cabana Winery, a good friend of mine, Robert, has some just wonderful wines. And the first course is going to be a cashew and cauliflower soup. We're going to top it with a baked brie. And we're going to use this triple cream Mount Tam brie. It's so good. It melts in your mouth.
Put it to work.
So
what can we do?
We boiled our cauliflower. Once the cauliflower is ready, it's just, you can tell it starts falling apart. These are the cashews, which I pureed in a food processor, and they're almost turned into butter already.
No salt, just
They're salted cashews.
But there's a lot of natural oils in that, right?
Yeah, they're so oily. If you continue to food process it, it will become butter. You can spread it on toast. Ooh. And then we're going to put some roasted garlic in that.
All of that? Wow, that's a lot of garlic.
Yeah. Well, see, since you roast it actually gets sweet. It takes the tang and all the harshness away from it. So this is going to boil a couple of minutes, and it'll start to incorporate a little. You just stir it up. Now, once the cashews are all melted into that, then you're going to add your heavy cream here.
And how much heavy cream is that? About
a cup?
That's
a cup. That's what makes it luscious and delicious. Now, your heavy cream is going to, you just want to cook that till you bring it to a boil.
Okay.
It's going to take us maybe, I don't know, a minute.
Okay.
Okay.
But I don't know how much time we have, so we'll speed up a little
bit. Okay, yeah.
So what we're going to do, we're going to add our ricotta cheese.
Okay.
That's a quarter cup of ricotta. We'll get these out of our way.
Lots of cheese.
Yeah, lots of cheese. That's the whole theme. And then we're going to add Asiago cheese.
Ooh, Asiago, okay.
And then a little salt and pepper to taste.
And this is all local cheese that you're
purchasing
here?
That's all local cheese.
Okay.
And that's, once that comes to a simmer, is what we're going to want to do is shut it off. Because then we're going to add sour cream. And if we keep it boiling, it'll separate out. It'll become a mess and it'll ruin our soup. So, we got the last hit. So, we'll turn that off. We'll add our sour cream and stir that down.
So, how long would it take someone at home to finally put this together?
A half hour.
From
your prep time. It's really not that much. Once
from
you get all your meat
time,
and pots together, everything in its place.
Okay. Stir, stir, stir.
You pretty much just have to boil it.
Okay.
And
so, waiting for the cashews to melt here.
Yeah, it'll incorporate.
And you were telling me during the break, we were talking a little bit about the Tabasco and lemon.
Yeah, at the end,
interesting combination.
At the end, you're going to squeeze a little lemon in there.
Okay.
And a little Tabasco. And what that's going to do is keep the flavor on your palate. It's going to grab your tongue.
Okay.
Okay. Not too spicy, though, right?
Not too spicy. Just maybe three dashes. Now,
all
your ingredients are in there.
Okay.
Okay.
Now you're going to put it in a food processor.
Okay.
Or a blender. You should have a blender.
Oh, okay.
Just process it till it's smooth. You're going to end up with a nice, creamy, smooth cheese like this.
That's the finished product.
That's the finished product. And then we have one on our, you're going to put it in your oven for about 7 to 10 minutes.
We have a miracle oven here at KCRA.
Bring it out, David.
We'll check out what happens.
There we go.
Okay.
And there's our finished product.
So is that really creamy?
It's very creamy. But see, I baked the brie on top till it gets a little golden brown, a little parsley for garnish.
Beautiful.
And before you put your brie on your soup, you might want to put it.
Okay, I want to try this.
Put one saltine cracker on
there. Is there a spoon for David as well?
We'll let you try it, and then we'll find another spoon while we go here.
I have a spoon. Let's find your spoon here.
That is fabulous.
Isn't that delicious?
Wow.
Well, our spoon's hidden, so
we did post the recipe on our website, kcra.com. You can go there, catch this, make this fabulous dish. Thanks to Evan for joining us, and you have a great rest of your day.
Thank you.
That's terrific.